What's up, y'all? It's your girl SA, and I'm back on another video. It's Best of the West Part 2, 90s style. I appreciate all the love from the first video. Same rules apply. So, with that being said, it's gonna have a group on there, maybe. It's definitely gonna have some bae rappers on there. So, make sure you like, subscribe, and comment, and let's go.
To the bathroom, I brush my teeth, look in the mirror, seen a G. Then he merged up the duck to a pancake foe, so I can go knock a hoe like a pro. And I tiptoe and top cat liquor store to buy some drink and zigzags for this thing. The very same blind, I'm just begging for change, getting drunk, telling lies, it's the same old thing. Now I'm rolling down from the lane, by the curb, pushing false gate, chat, pine, whoopers with reaper. See my homie, little man, look a wide, crazy.
Coming in at number 10, we got Sugar Free from Pomona, California. Baby, why you bullshitting? That's one of my favorite joints by him. My favorite tape by him gotta be Street Gospel. He is a pimp turned rapper. And when I tell you that his rhymes are so dope, his whole style, honestly, he be giving out free game on the interludes. If you ever watch any of his interviews, you can hear the gems that be coming out of him. So you gotta pay attention, you feel me? He is definitely a West Coast legend. He's always showing love to the new West Coast rappers. So shout out to Sugar Free. Coming in at number 9, we got The Foreside from Los Angeles, California. And when I say the epitome of real hip-hop, this is real hip-hop. You know, there was a time where there was nothing but gangster music, and this gave hip-hop a new flair. Like, alternative hip-hop was something groovy to me, and that's why I fell in love with it. Their tracks like Running, Drop, and Passing Me By will always live on with me. And a plus, with the new kids finding out what real hip-hop is, their music will always last. And they're still out here doing their thing, doing tours and everything, so shout out to them. Coming in at number 8, we got the Loomies from Oakland, California, a two-man duo. I personally think that they're underrated. I also think that their album is fire. They have so many hits on there. Some people want to say a one-hit wonder group, but that's not the case. If you don't listen to somebody's album, you won't know what other good songs they have on there except for that one radio play song. So with that being said, songs like Yellow Brick Road, Why You Wanna Play a Hate on Me, and Broke Hoes are some actually good songs. Like I said before, the music industry is going to make you think that they're a one-hit wonder, but they're not. They're still out here getting money and doing shows. So it's nothing but all respect for the Loomies. Shout out to them. Coming at number 7, we got Spice One from Haywood, California. This dude is a certified legend in the streets. He does represent Northern Cal, which is Oakland, San Francisco area, with songs like Strap on My Side, 187 Proof, and Welcome to the Ghetto. His catalog is forever fire. He's still out here doing his thing, doing shows, interviews, and showing love to the new West Coast, like Little Easy E. When I say that he has so many gems in his interviews, go watch him. He knows what he's talking about. Shout out to Spice One. At number 6, we got Cypress Hill from Southgate, California. We all know in the 90s, everybody was trying to be different and have unique flows, but I can honestly say that Cypress Hill was one of those different bands. It kind of confused me when I was growing up because I thought they was a rock band, but they're a rap group. It's kind of a mixture in between both. They kind of go hand in hand together, and some of my favorite tracks by them is Roll It Up, Light It Up, Smoke It Up, Inhale, Exhale, How I Could Just Kill a Man, and also Dr. The Green Thumb. When I tell you that Be Real has one of those voices that you cannot forget, it kind of echoes in the back of your mind, but you got to show some love from Cypress Hill. Number 5, we got Selly Cell from Vallejo, California. This dude was once signed to E-40 Slick Ritty Records with hits like Gin With No Juice, Funk For Life, and Heat For Your Ass. And also, my favorite song is Going Down Tonight. This dude is a producer, a writer, and everything in between. I would like to think that sometimes in the music industry, you don't get the type of backing that you need. But nevertheless, where you come from is always going to hold you down. So in my opinion, Celly Cell is definitely a California legend. You feel me? A West Coast legend, because he put it down. He put in that work and still going hard to this day. So shout out to Celly Cell. And number four, we got Corrupt from Hawthorne, California. Of course, Corrupt was originally born and raised in Philadelphia and moved to LA at 16. But nevertheless, he has put in the work, appearing on Dr. Dre's album, The Chronic, and Snoop Dogg's Doggy Style, and also making a name for himself with his two-man band, The Dog Pound, with Das Dillinger. A couple of my favorite tracks by Corrupt gotta be Seawalk, of course, New York, New York with The Dog Pound, and The Streets Is a Mother. Corrupt is lately been involved in the cannabis business with his weed called Corrupt's Moon Rocks. I've heard that it's been some pretty good stuff. He's a producer, actor, writer, and all of that. Coming in at number three, we got E-40 from Vallejo, California. This man has been getting it since the beginning of time. He started a group with his brother, his sister, and his cousin called The Click. He has his own record label called Slick Ritty Records and his own ice cream company called Goon With A Spoon. I just recently found out he has his own VSOP called Tycoon. I definitely gonna have to try that out. And some of my favorite tracks by E-40 gotta be I Hope I Don't Go Back, Captain Save-A-Ho, and Tell Me When To Get. Tell Me When To Get. Everybody was on that hyphy scene like forever. The music, the business, and especially his slang, and most importantly his style. Every time you see him, he's always iced out with the beanies and everything. Y'all remember when E-40 had the locks? E-40 definitely had the locks. With that being said, you already know he's a legend, so there we go, E-40. Coming in at number two, we got the Short Dog in the house from East Oakland, California. Too Short has been known for putting sex and pimping in his music, just to let you know how it was and what it is. Then on top of that, by the time 1996 came, he was already on his 10th album. He has 20 studio albums as we speak, getting it out the trunk. And did you know that he has his own pre-rolls called Too Short Sticks? I'm definitely going to have to go check that out. And plus the slang, the production, and everything about him has always been so smooth and cool. Some of my favorite songs by Too Short is Getting It, Nasty Rhymes, Baby D, and what's my favorite word, bitch? Well, we gotta say it like Short, Blow the Whistle, of course. Coming in at number one, we got Mac Drizzy from Vallejo, California, with his style, his rhymes, his fashion, his facial expressions. You just gotta always love Mac for being charismatic and humble. He definitely had a lot of energy. He is a key figure in the hyphy movement that came out of the Bay scene in the early 2000s. He is considered a key pioneer that fueled into popularity and mainstream. Some of my favorite songs by him would be Miss You, About Your Dough, and Tizzle Dance, and of course Feeling Myself. He had his own independent record label called Tizzle Entertainment, and unfortunately Mac did pass away on November 1st 2004. His case is still unsolved. He will forever live in our hearts with his slang, his music, and his fashion. R.I.P. Mac Drake.